好，欢迎来到这一期的双语故事会，我是这一期的主讲人悠悠阿姨，这位是我的小助手 Luna。
Say hi to the camera。
Hi。
还有我的另外一个小助手 Isaac。
Hi。
Hello everyone, welcome to the bilingual story time. I am Miss Yu Yu. I have two assistants today. This is Luna.
Luna, can you say hi again?
Hi.
And Isaac.
Hi. Oh!
今天我们会讲两个故事。
下一个。
今天我们会讲两个故事。第一个故事是 Gertrude McFuzz.
I'm crazy today.
The first story we're going to read is called
Gertrude McFuzz.
By?
I'm going to trace the word.
Oh, by? Gertrude McFuzz is by?
Dr. Seuss.
And the second story, 第二个故事叫做
The Snitches.
The Snitches.
Dr. Seuss.
There once was a girl bird named
Gertrude McFuzz,
and she had the smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad.
从前有一只小鸟叫做 Gertrude McFuzz。它有一条又短又平凡的小尾巴，只有一根垂头丧气的小羽毛。Gertrude为此伤透了心。
For there was another young bird that she knew, a fancy young birdie named
Lovely Low.
And instead of one feather behind, she had two. Poor Gertrude, whenever she happened to spy,Miss Lowly Low flying by in the sky, she got very
jealous.
She frowned and she pouted. Then one day, she got awfully mad and she shouted, "This just isn't fair. I have one, she has two. I must have a tail just like Lowly Low."
因为就在他家附近住着另外一只漂亮的小鸟，叫做 Lowly Low， 它的尾巴有两根又长又美的羽毛。每次 Gertrude 看到 Lola 从天边飞过，都羡慕得不得了，羡慕得她又皱眉又撅嘴。有一天 ，Gertrude 生气了，她大声地喊道：“这也太不公平了！”为什么它有两根，我却只有一根？我一定要想办法长出和 Lola 一样漂亮的尾巴。So she flew to her uncle, a doctor named
Dick,
whose office was high in a tree by the
lake.
And she cried, "Uncle Doctor, oh please, do you know of some kind of a pill that will make my tail grow?"said the doctor. "Such talk! How absurd! Your tail is just right for your kind of bird."
于是 Gertrude 飞去找他的医生叔叔 Dick. 他伤心地对着叔叔说，医生叔叔，你知道有什么方法让我的尾巴再长一根羽毛吗？
叔叔说，傻孩子，你这个想法可真奇怪。你这样的小鸟就应该是这样的尾巴呀。Then Gertrude had tantrums. She raised such a din that finally her uncle, the doctor, gave in. And he told her just where she could find such a pill. On a pillberry vine on the top of the
hill.
Oh, thank you, chirped Gertrude McFuzz. And she flew right straight to the hill where the pale berry grew.
Gertrude 可听不进去，她生气的大发脾气。叔叔招架不住，只好说，好吧，好吧，我告诉你一个秘密。在很远很远的地方有一座山，山顶上长着一种羽毛藤。只要吃了藤上结的果子，就可以长出新羽毛来了。Gertrude 听了二话不说，立刻往羽毛藤的方向飞去。
Yes,
There was the vine, and as soon as she saw it, she plucked off a berry and she started to gnaw it. It tasted just awful, almost made her sick. But she wanted that tail, so she swallowed it quick. Then she felt something happen. She felt a small
twitch,
as if she'd been tapped down behind by a
small switch.
And Gertrude looked around, and she cheered. It was true. Two feathers, exactly like Lola Lola. Gertrude 飞到了山顶，果然找到了羽毛藤。她激动地赶紧摘下一颗果子，吞进肚子里。果子难吃极了，差点没让葛处吐出来，可他一点都不在意。他耐心地等了一会儿，突然他感觉背后有一阵抽动，转过头一看，天哪，是真的，羽毛藤果然名不虚传，他现在有两根羽毛了，和 Lola 一模一样了。 Then she got an idea. Now I know what I'll do.I'll grow a tail better than Lola Lilo. These pills that grow feathers are working just fine. So she nibbled another one off the vine. 忽然，葛处有了一个新的想法。现在我知道了羽毛藤的秘密，我可以长一根比 Lola 更美的尾巴。想着想着，他就又吞下了一颗果子。She felt a new twitch, and then Gertrude yelled, Whee! Miss Lola has only just two. I have
three.
When Lola Lilo sees this beautiful stuff, she'll fall right down flat on her face, sure enough. I'll show her who's pretty. I certainly will.Why, I'll make my tail even prettier still. 然后他的后背又抽动了一下，他开心地欢呼起来。哈哈， Lola 小姐姐只有两根羽毛，而我现在有三根啦。下次 Lola 看到我美丽的尾巴，肯定会羡慕地马上从天上摔下来。我来告诉她谁更美，等着瞧吧，我还可以让我的尾巴变得更美。She snatched at those berries that grew on that vine. She gobbled down 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And she didn't stop eating, young Gertrude McFuzz, till she'd eaten 3 dozen. That's all that there was. 于是葛处又开始吃藤上的果子，不知不觉，他把藤上所有的果子全给吞下去了。Then the feathers popped out, with a zen, with a zing. They blossomed like flowers that bloom in the spring, all fit for a queen. What a sight to behold! They sparkled like diamonds and gumdrops and
gold!
Like silk, like spaghetti, like satin, like lace. They burst out like rockets all over the place.They waved in the air and they swished in the breeze, and some were as long as branches of trees, and still they kept growing. They popped and they popped, until long about sundown when finally they stopped. 于是他的后背开始不停地抽动，美丽的羽毛不停地像烟花一样绽放开来。像花一样鲜艳，像宝石一样灿烂，漂亮极了。羽毛不停地往外蹦，长得像树枝一样长了。蹦啊蹦啊蹦啊蹦啊，终于在太阳下山之前才慢慢地停了下来。And now, giggled Gertrude, the next thing to do is fly right straight home and show Lola Lilo. And when Lola sees these, why, her face will get red and she'll let out a scream and she'll fall right down dead. 葛柱开心极了，他笑呵呵地说，现在我要飞回家去，把我这美丽的新尾巴展示给露露看，他看见以后肯定会气得尖叫起来，然后从天上掉下来，哈哈哈哈。
Then she spread her wings to take off from the ground, but with all those feathers, she weighed 90 pounds.She yanked and she pulled and she let out a squawk, but that bird couldn't fly, couldn't run, couldn't walk.
于是他张开尾巴想飞起来，可是拖着他新尾巴上的几百根新羽毛，他根本动不了。他拖呀扯呀，用尽了力气，可是连一步都走不动。
And all through that night she was stuck on that hill.And Gertrude McFuss might be stuck up there still if her good Uncle Dick hadn't heard the girl yelp. He rushed to her rescue and brought along help.
于是葛柱一整晚都被困在了山顶上。幸运的是，他的医生叔叔听见他远处传来的呼救声，带着帮手一起上山去救他了。
To lift Gertrude up almost broke all their beaks.And to fly her back home, it took almost 2 weeks. And then it took almost another week more to pull out those feathers. My Gertrude was sore.
几十只小鸟帮着葛柱叼着它的大尾巴，飞了整整两个礼拜才回到家。之后又花了一个礼拜的时间，把那些没用的新羽毛一根一根的全部拔下来。天哪，葛柱疼坏了。
And finally, when all of the pulling was done, Gertrude, behind her, again, had just one. That one little feather she had as a starter. But now, that's enough, because now she is
smarter.
后来，所有的新羽毛都拔完之后，葛柱又只剩下之前那根小小的羽毛。现在的他很满足，因为现在的他变聪明了。The end.